Hello everyone, this is Edunik. Today we are going to take a look at the superposition theorem in circuit analysis. Superposition is a broad concept applied almost in all disciplines. Superposition, the basic concept goes like this. The effect of numerous factors at any point is given by the algebraically summing the effects due to each individual source taken one at a time. So the superposition theorem in circuit analysis has the same concept, but the proper definition is, in any linear circuit containing two or more sources, the response in any element is equal to the algebraic sum of responses caused by individual sources alone, while other sources are kept non-operative. So let's understand the same with a problem. Before going into the problem, you need to understand a very basic property or principle. So while doing a problem, if we have to remove a voltage source or a current source, we replace it with its internal resistance. In ideal cases, the voltage source is replaced by a short circuit, whereas a current source is replaced by an open circuit. That is, this is equivalent to zero resistance and this infinite resistance. So we are given a circuit like this and we have to find out the voltage across the 2 ohm resistor right here. So to find out the voltage drop, we can see that there are 3 sources, 2 voltage sources and 1 current source. So to find out the voltage drop across the 2 ohm resistor, we have to consider each individual source separately and find out the voltage drop across the 2 ohm resistor in each case and sum it algebraically. So the first step, we take the 10 volt voltage source. So we activate the 10 volt voltage source and deactivate the other 2 sources, resistors stays the same. As you can see, the 2 ampere source when open circuited, no current flows through this branch, so this 3 ohm resistor becomes insignificant. So I'm not drawing this 5 ohm. And the 20 volt source is short circuited. Now we get a simple circuit like this, in which we have to find out the voltage drop across the 2 ohm resistor. I am taking node analysis. To do that, I am taking this node as A and with voltage V. I'm writing the node equations V minus 10 by 10 plus V by 20 plus V by 7. Equal to 0. Solving, I got the value as 3.41 volt for VA. Now to find out the voltage drop across 2 ohm resistor, this voltage is 3.41, so I apply voltage divider rule. Now V1 equal to V by 7 into 2 equal to 0.97 volts. So now we got the voltage drop across 2 ohm resistor with respect to the 10 volt source. Now we move on to the next voltage source for the 20 volt source alone, like this. And now we have to apply some method to find out the voltage drop across 2 ohm resistor. So here also I am applying the nodal analysis. Node A with voltage V, and this is the reference voltage of voltage 0. So writing the node equation, V by 10 plus V by 20 plus V minus 20 by 7 equal to 0. Solving, I got the value of V as 9.76 volts. So now we have to find out the voltage drop across 2 ohm resistor, which is V of 2 ohm equal to I of 2 ohm into 2 which is given by V minus 20 by 7 into 2 which is equal to minus 2.92 volt. This is, let me name it as V2 due to the second source. The voltage drop across 2 ohm is minus 2.92. For the 2 ampere current source, I deactivated or short circuited the two voltage sources and got the circuit like this. Now, as the 10 ohm and 20 ohm are parallel, I grouped it as 20 by 3 ohm right here. Now, I'm attempting to write the super mesh equations. Let it be I1 and I2, the two loop currents. Now, the first loop equation is 20 by 3. I1 plus 2 I1 plus 5 I2 equal to 0. Similarly, second loop equation I2 minus I1 equal to 2 amperes, that is 2. Now the two equations can be solved and we get the value of I1 as 0.73 amperes, which in turn gives us the voltage drop across 2 ohm as I1 into 2 equal to that is V3 equal to 1.46 volt. As the sign of voltage is similar to V2, we put a negative sign. Now we got V1, V2 and V3. Which can be algebraically summed. V1 0.97, V2 minus 2.92, V3 is 1.46, which can be algebraically summed. We get V1 plus V2 plus V3 equal to 0.97 in the first case, first source, minus 2.92 the second, and minus 1.46 in the third, which gives a total of minus 3.41 volt. This is the actual voltage drop in the 2 ohm resistor due to the combined effect of all the three sources. So this is all in superposition analysis for solving circuits. If you have any doubts regarding the solving procedures, you can refer my previous tutorials on nodal supermesh, etc. So this is a simple method which you can master with few problems. Few more complicated problems can be found in your textbooks, so practice with my problems, and also don't forget to subscribe my channel and like this video. Thank you.